Praise God, dear heart. I want to thank you for joining me today on Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I am your host, Evangelist King. Holy Ghost Fire Talk is going to start a new program effective July the 11th, in which I will still be hosting Holy Ghost Fire Talk. But now I'm making it available after the teachings, the Fire Talk teachings, that you can feel free to ask questions. So after the teaching, there will be a Q&A. So now, in order for you to join in to our program, Holy Ghost Fire Talk, you can call dial-in number 712-770-4005, and then you enter participant code 746391. Now, in the beginning of the teaching, everyone will be muted, and as I am teaching, if you have any questions, then you can click from your phone star six. And what would happen, it would place you in the Q&A queue. Therefore, it will notify me to let me know that you have a question, and you will be next in line, in which I will, after the teacher now, in which I will unmute you so you can ask your question. Now, for those of you who only care to just listen, we still have the listener number in which you can listen, and that number is 605-477-4740. I will still be coming on every Monday and Friday at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. Then, dear heart, it depends on the participation. I may end up changing the day and the time. Again, that's going to depend on how much participation that I get, because I know the majority of you may be still at work, working during 12 noon Eastern Standard Time on Monday and Friday. So again, this is Holy Ghost Fire Talk. The program is changing, in which now it will give you an opportunity to ask questions. So for the time being, again, I'll be coming on Monday and Fridays at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time, in which I will teach from the living word, from the word of God. And you can dial in number 712-770-4005 if you would like to ask questions after the teaching. And then you enter participant code 746391. So praise the living God. But right now, I just want to briefly talk about in Hebrews, the second chapter, starting at verse 1. You know, the word of God warns us, dear heart, that we should pay attention. We should pay attention to the word of God. Again, the word of God warns us in Hebrews, the second chapter, verse 1, that we should pay attention. Pay attention to the word of God. You know, a lot of times we say we're paying attention, but we actually is not giving God our undivided attention. God wants our undivided attention. That means that when we hear his word or we are listening to his word, we are supposed to listen with all our heart. And that means we tune everything else out. Have you ever started talking to a person and you're talking and talking, you notice they're in a time zone? Why? Because they have tuned you out. Something else had captured their attention. Something else has captured their focus. Well, God wants us to give him our undivided attention. He don't want nothing else to capture our attention, our focus, or our interest. You know, we have many interests, but the main interest that is needful is knowing who we are in Christ Jesus, also who Jesus is in us. You know, Mary set us that perfect example. She only had one interest, and that was Jesus. Her sister Martha. Her sister Martha became upset with her because her interest was not like her interest. And she went to Jesus about Martha. But Jesus did not rebuke Mary. He did not stop Mary because he let Martha know that Mary chose the only thing that was needful. Mary's design was to know all she could about Jesus, because when he spoke, it gave life to her. She'd never been in a conversation like that. And that is still God today, his word. So Hebrews 2 verse 1 tells us that we must pay most careful attention, therefore, to what we have heard. That means the word of God. The word of God in which we have heard. Now, he's not talking about the gossip that we may have heard, that we don't pay attention to, lies that we may have heard, that we don't pay attention to. But he is talking about the word of God. We are to pay attention to the word of God. And he said, again, we must pay the most careful attention, therefore, to what we have heard, so that we do not drift away. Remember, faith in God comes by hearing his word. So that's why we must pay a careful attention to what we have heard, the word of God. Because if we don't pay attention to the word of God, it would drift away from us. Therefore, our faith in God will drift away from us. Remember, Jesus warned us about how the devil does. And you know, and the Lord gave me clearly understanding of this analogy in his word when I was a young girl. You know, I could not understand the word of God, but I noted as I meditated on his word, his mercy and grace gave me understanding. So he told me, as he said in his word, when we hear his word, dear heart, we must guard his word, must pay careful attention to his word, because that's the only way we end up acting on his word, when we pay attention to his word. So when the word of God is first spoken to us, it's not deeply rooted down in our heart yet. Just like when a farmer plants his seed into the ground, where that seed has not been rooted deep down in that soil yet. Okay? So God's word is a seed. It's like a seed. So when we first hear it, we must guard it, because it's on the surface of the ground of our heart, the word of God. Now remember, even in the natural, when that farmer plants his seed, he has to guard that seed, because he knows that seed is not deeply rooted in the earth, because he knows there are birds, there are crows who are looking at him. As soon as he's not around, they're just going to go there and peck and eat that seed, because they don't have far to dig down into the soil, because that seed haven't been deeply rooted yet. So the farmer has to watch his seeds. He has to watch his seeds. Where his seeds are planted, he has to watch. He has to guard it. Same way, dear heart, we must guard. We must guard and pay careful attention to what we heard, which is the word of God. We must guard it. Why? Because there are some spiritual crows, which are devils, that is watching us. And if we're not guarding and paying close attention to God's word when it's spoken to us, remember, have not been given enough time to deeply sink down into the soil of our heart. It's just on the surface. So those spiritual crows who are devils who are watching is going to do everything in their power to get us to take our eyes off of the seed, which is the word of God that's on the surface of our heart, so it cannot take a deep root into our heart. And they would do anything in their power to prevent it from being deeply rooted. And so, dear heart, when we're careless about the ways and the things of God, about the word of God, don't pay attention to what we have heard, those spiritual crows, which are devils, is going to destroy the seed, which is the word of God, in our heart. It's like in the natural. And the Lord reminded us that in his word, when he compared his word to a seed. And he also let us know the condition of each and everybody's heart. We have a different type of heart. We have some people have a stony heart. The heart is very hard. And so when they hear the word of God, it can't take root. Because in the natural realm, if you try to go planting seed into a ground that's rock, full of rocks, ain't no way. It cannot take root. That is not good soil. So that's why the Lord wants us to guard our heart. Guard what we have heard so that we don't drift away. We don't drift away. Have you ever noticed how you will hear the word of God? One moment, the next moment, someone else is bringing totally different news. And Satan, remember those spiritual crows are always watching to steal the seed, which is the word of God, that is on the surface, been planted on the surface of your heart. They want to prevent it from taking root down into your heart. Because remember now, again, faith comes by hearing the word of God. Faith in God comes by hearing the word of God. And as we hear the word of God and guard the word of God, it sinks deeper and deeper down into our heart, dear heart. So again, remember those spiritual crows out there. Watch, pay most careful attention to what you hear so that we don't drift away from God. Because when we reject God's word, we actually have rejected him, because he is his word. He is the living word. He said, for since the message spoken through angels was binding, and every violation and disobedience received its just punishment, how shall we escape if we ignore so great a salvation? See, dear heart, we cannot ignore the salvation of the Lord. We cannot ignore the word of God, because the word of God is binding. It's binding, dear heart. And there will be a punishment. You know, I'm reminded of a young lady on a few days ago that had a deliverance session. And as I talked to her, the Holy Spirit was giving me more revelation and understanding of what her heart wanted. What her heart truly wanted. Now, out of her mouth came one thing or one interpretation of her wants, but the truth of her wants was in her heart, and the Holy Spirit let me see that. So her reasoning for wanting to be delivered was not an appropriate reasoning. And so as I'm listening to her, my heart went out to her in sorrow. I really felt godly sorry for this young woman. And I mentioned to her, kindly and lovingly as possible, mentioned to her, as the Holy Spirit gave me, he told me to tell her, there is an end. Now, what the Holy Spirit was saying, dear heart, We can continue to ignore the word of God. This young lady knew she was living in sexual sin. She wasn't blind. She knew she was rebellion, being in rebellion against God, being in disobedient to God. But at the same time, Satan was having her to ignore the punishment of her sin. Flatly just to ignore the punishment of her sin. Getting her to ignore the violation and the disobedience. Getting her to ignore that. All she wanted to be delivered from demons, but her purpose or reason to be delivered from them is so that she can continue in her life of sin with a man that was not her husband. You see. So the Lord told me to tell her there is an end. Even though, dear heart, we know we are doing wrong. When you are doing wrong and you know it wrong, the Holy Spirit have to convict you. But you are ignoring the Holy Spirit conviction. The Lord say to such people, there is an end. Satan get you to ignore that there is an end. And it's not a good end. It's an end where you will not just suffer on this earth, because the suffering on this earth does not compare to the suffering that happens in hell. There's just no comparison. So the Lord said, remember, there is an end. You cannot choose to continue to ignore the violation and disobedience of God's word, because punishment shall come. No one shall escape punishment if they choose to ignore such a great salvation. You know, the grace of God, God loving grace and mercy, Jesus have already given us a way out, dear heart. Dear heart, when we stand before God, we truly indeed will stand before him excuseless, because the Holy Spirit convicts us all. Even the Holy Spirit convict Muslims, those who are in the Muslim religion, who is separated from God's servants, and that they cannot minister God's grace and mercy to them. The Holy Spirit even ministers to them in their dreams. Jesus appears before them personally. Jesus said he appears before Muslims personally and more often than he do his own children. Jesus does that. That's the reason why anyone who leaves this earth, you can cool believe they have been given a chance to change for themselves. They have been given their own free will to choose which way they want to go. So that's why we all going to stand before him excuseless. Dear heart, there is an end. You know, regardless of what we're going through, what hard time we're going through, the time is going to come that there'll be nobody around you that can intervene for you and that can help you or walk with you through that valley of shadow of death. It is only Jesus Christ. So while we are still alive in our full capacity, in our full being, let us stop ignoring the punishment and the punishment and disobedience, the violations that we are committing against God. We need to stop ignoring it, because there will be an end. You know, Jesus said he have no pleasure in a sinner's death. A sinner is a person who willfully practices wrongdoing. And when they die, it don't give Jesus pleasure. It don't give him pleasure, dear heart. Praise his holy name. So the Lord is wanting us to pay attention. Pay attention to what we have already done. heard. Pay much careful heed to the things we have heard so that we won't drift away. Because again, when we fail to pay attention to God's word, we will drift away. Now, this salvation, which was first announced by the Lord, it was confirmed to us by those who heard him, and that is his apostles and Jesus' disciples even today. Disciples, someone who follows the Lord, learn of him. So salvation has been confirmed to us by those who have heard him. God also testified to it by signs, wonders, and various the gift of the Holy Spirit distributed according to his will. So again, dear heart, God is wanting us to pay attention to his word. Pay attention, dear heart. We should live, eat, and sleep God's word. That's who he is. God is the living word. That's our daily bread, is the word of God. You know, just let us not just be hearer only, but doer. So in other words, when we pay attention to God's word, we are more than just a hearer of his word. We are also a doer of his word. Praise his holy name. When we pay attention to his word, dear heart, we will fear the Lord. Fear the Lord. We will fear the Lord. We won't be so quick to sin and continue to sin against God, because we know that he's a just God, that he is a rewarder. He's a rewarder. He gives to every man according to their own doing. He's faithful to his word. We fear the Lord. I don't sin because I don't sin. I fear the Lord. I mean, especially when you know truth and you just act as though God is not faithful to his word, and you turn up your nose and turn up your head and you with your defiant self and you just rebel and sin against him, knowing that you are doing what the Lord said not do. Whew. You are placing yourself in a dangerous position. Judgment can come in a split second. You know, a few years ago, that's what happened to a well-known minister of the gospel. Well-known minister of the gospel. People loved him. Churches invited him to come and minister. It was reported after his death, his invitations totaled over $38,000 a month. People just invited him over. But at the same time, he involved himself in secret sin, preaching the word one moment in front of people, but behind closed doors, he's sinning against God, just ignoring the Lord. One day, he won't even thinking about it. Didn't even think it would happen. Judgment came quickly while he was in the act of his sins. And people to this day don't even believe the reports about how he was found and what he was involved in. Christian people don't even believe it. Why? Because they believe a lie more so than they believe truth. Dear heart, as the Lord told this young lady, an end is coming. Judgment is coming. And it's going to start at the house of God. So again, today, in this brief message on Holy Ghost Fire Talk, and those of you who tuning in on the radio program, Holy Ghost Fire Talk Radio, from now on, you know, I'm going to try to make this a live broadcast. This is not pre-recorded. Of course, you listen to in the archive. Now it's pre-recorded. But right now, as it's happening now, as you listen to me on Holy Ghost Fire Talk Radio, this is a live recording. So remember, effective July 11th, Holy Ghost Fire Talk program is going to change, in which I'm giving you an opportunity to ask questions after the teaching, and you can tune in if you have questions. You think maybe you want to have questions after the teaching, that's when you can call conference dial-in number 712-770-4005, and you enter participant code 746-391. But for those who just want to continue listening, you can either go to our website at spiritradio.us for Holy Ghost Fire Talk Radio, or you can call our listener number, 605-477-4740, or be sure to download our free mobile apps, and you have access to our radio and television programs on your mobile phone. And you can visit thechildrenmike.org and click on free apps to download our Android or Apple apps. Okay, they are free. So praise the living God. So I look forward to coming back on again July 11th, Monday at 12 noon. Again, as I stated earlier, it depends on the participation. I may end up changing the time for Holy Ghost Fire Talk due to people's work schedule. But again, they're only going to depend on the participation. So, dear heart, praise God, and remember, in all you're getting, be sure you get understanding.